Welcome back for some national news. After spending 9 months in jail, Suresh Kalmadi, the former Commonwealth Games Organizing Committee chairman, has got bail. The Delhi High Court granted him bail on a surety of 5 lakh rupees. Former Organizing Committee Director General V.K. Verma has also been granted bail. Kalmadi, Verma and 9 others have been accused of allegedly awarding a contract to a Swiss firm to install a timing scoring result system for the games at an exorbitant rate. That had led to a loss of over 90 crore rupees. Kalmadi has been lodged in Tihar jail since April last year.
पहली बात है, we welcome it. इससे एक बात बड़ी प्रूव हुई है कि जो हायर कोर्ट्स हैं, वो रूल ऑफ लॉ को एस्टेब्लिश करने में फुली अवेयर हैं और करती हैं. इससे इंडिया की जो डेमोक्रेटिक सिस्टम की बहुत बड़ी जीत है. और दूसरा सीबीआई को एक और ये एक मैसेज है कि वाई यू जस्ट फॉर नथिंग डिप्राइव पीपल कि वो अपने आप को डिफेंड ना कर पाए. अब 9 महीने जेल रहे हैं और सिर्फ इसलिए कि केस ट्रायल पे है. तो ये तो एक सीबीआई को भी एक मैसेज है कि दे शुड आल्सो इम्प्रूव इन इस बात के लिए.
एज यू आर अवेयर, मिस्टर कलमाडी वाज अरेस्टेड ऑन इन द मंथ ऑफ अप्रैल एंड इट्स बीन 8 months इन कनेक्शन विद द टीएसआर एफआईआर फाइल बाय द सीबीआई इन द टीएसआर केस. ही हैज बीन रिलीज्ड ऑन बेल टुडे. And basically, the arguments before the court were that the investigation has been completed, charge sheet has been filed, and you don't require Mr. Kalmadi for the purpose of any further investigation. And secondly, that he has not influenced the witness and he has cooperated with the investigation. And particularly in line of the judgment of the Supreme Court in Sanjay Chandra's case, which said that the bail is a rule and a jail is an exception. So all these arguments were placed before the court and finally he has been released on bail.
A reprieve for Pakistani Prime Minister Yusuf Raza Gilani, as the Supreme Court has given the Prime Minister 2 weeks in the contempt case against him. The case will be heard on 1st February. But the relief comes after some tough questions were posed by the top court to the government. Hearing the case, the Supreme Court asked why the government had been silent on the graft cases for 2 years now. The Prime Minister, though, has been exempted from the next court appearance. Gilani, who was slapped with a contempt notice for not opening corruption cases against President Zardari, told the court that presidents across the world enjoy immunity and the Pakistani constitution also allows its president some immunity. Striking a conciliatory note, the Prime Minister also said he respects the judiciary and served a jail term earlier on. The entire route to the Supreme Court virtually turned into a fortress with massive security on the ground and in the air. Many helicopters were hovering around the route and the Supreme Court complex. The Gujarat government today moved the Supreme Court, challenging the Gujarat High Court verdict that had upheld the appointment of the state Lok Ayukta by the governor. The Modi government appeal says that the High Court order is wrong and needs to be kept aside. The appeal states that proper procedure has not been followed in the appointment of the Lok Ayukta. Delhi High Court adjourned the case hearing of filed by Facebook and Google to February 2nd. The internet giants had challenged the summons issued to their executives by the lower court for objectionable content posted on their websites. During the last hearing, Google and Facebook had argued that there was no way for them to screen content before it was posted online. Both companies are among the 21 firms whose executives have been summoned to appear in person in a lower court on March 13th for allegedly hosting obscene and objectionable content. During her visit to Mathura today, the media got too close to Opera and the bodyguards. They had pushed her back, leading to a brawl. No one has heard, but the bodyguards broke some cameras. In Mumbai too, the media had followed Opera across the city, covering the visit very closely. What's the trick to get your movie a hit at the box office? We'll tell you the secret on the other side of the break.